According to a new report, experts say that we have until 2030 to avoid catastrophe. If unprecedented changes are not made and made soon, there will be irreversible damage to the planet.
A heat wave across Europe is right now setting record temperatures. France recorded its hottest day in history on Friday. There have been wildfires in Spain and Germany with heat records in Poland, the Czech Republic, and Switzerland.
As has been widely reported, the Earth is at the start of the sixth mass extinction in its history. A new study has concluded that more than 40% of insect species are declining and a third are endangered.
Higher temperatures are already happening. They will increase deaths. Food and waterborne illnesses will spread. Wildfires, as we've just seen so painfully in California, will increase. Floods, as we've just seen after hurricanes, will be more frequent. Asthma and allergies will be worse. Crop production will decline because of high temperatures and drought.
Climate change is jeopardizing food and water security and threatening the very foundations on which communities are built.
The very livability of our planet is at stake, not in 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, but right now.
We would have $600 trillion of climate damages. That's double all the wealth that exists in the world today.
It also poses a risk to human health, from bad air due to wildfires to the spread of disease. One in six species around the globe is threatened by climate change.
Our civilization is being sacrificed for the opportunity of a very small number of people to continue making enormous amounts of money. Our biosphere is being sacrificed. It is the sufferings of the many which pay for the luxuries of the few. If I have children, maybe they will ask me about you. Maybe they will ask why you didn't do anything while there still was time to act. You say you love your children above all else, and yet you're stealing their future in front of their very eyes. Until you start focusing on what needs to be done rather than what is politically possible, there is no hope of a crisis without treating it as a crisis. We need to keep the fossil fuels in the ground, and we need to focus on equity.
This is only going to change with a political struggle.
Do things that make them listen, make our voice heard, get in the media with these kind of peaceful acts of mass civil disobedience.
Nothing that happened in the past until a few years ago is going to affect the climate going forward. The thing that will write that story is the actions that we take moving into the future. We did the damage to it. We can undo the damage to it.
It's up to our generation to take up the fight. It's up to us to do something about it.
If we don't take action, the collapse of our civilizations and the extinction of much of the natural world is on the horizon.
For the sake of life in this beautiful living planet, I ask you to stand on the right side of history.